Tell me when it's up. Is it up?
Hi, this is Matt with Bob Johnson's Computer Stuff. Today we're going to be doing a video on how to install the wireless WAN card on a CF19 Mark IV and a CF31 Mark I. We're going to start off with the CF19 Mark IV. The first thing you're going to want to do is, before you even open your computer, you're going to want to remove the battery. And then, to install the wireless WAN or mobile broadband card, it's as simple as removing this smaller plate in the back. There's four screws holding it in place. Then just lift the plate up, and on the inside you'll see that there's, if you have a wireless WAN card in here already, it'll be right here, and you'll have a black cable going into the onto the main connector and a green cable going into the auxiliary connector. If you already have a card in, just go ahead and remove those cables and take the two screws out that hold the card in place. And then the card will lift up at an angle and pull out. This here, for example, is a Gobi 2000 card. It's a multi-carrier mobile broadband card that you can use. Once you have the old card removed, you can go ahead and put your new card in. This card here, there's nothing wrong with it. This is just for example, so I'm just going to go ahead and reinsert this card. And then go ahead and put the two screws back in place to hold the card in place. Once you've slid the card back into its position. And reconnect the cables. These cables just connect the mobile broadband card to the antennas. Go ahead and place the plate back on. And screw the screws back on the plate. To hold the plate back into position. There are many different versions of the mobile broadband card. The most common of which are the Gobi 1000, Gobi 2000, and then there's a Verizon 4G card that's also common. Regardless of what card you use, the install procedure is the same. After you've physically installed the card, you're going to want to go ahead and put your battery back in and just turn your computer on and boot into BIOS by hitting the F2 button, so you can check BIOS to make sure that it's enabled in BIOS. To check to make sure it's enabled, you'll want to go to the third tab, which is labeled Advanced, and go down to where it says Wireless Configuration and hit Enter. Once you're there, look for the wireless WAN. If you see that it's enabled, then your card's enabled. The next time you restart your computer and boot into the operating system, all you'll have to do is install your software for your card. I'll show you here shortly after I do the install for the 31 where you can go to locate your drivers. The drivers for the mobile broadband cards are generally in the same spot, and I'll show you that shortly. It doesn't matter if it's for a CF19, CF30, CF31, doesn't matter. The drivers are all the same. So I'm going to shut this down and I'm going to show you the process on the CF31. Let me just get the 31 into position. Okay, as with the CF19, the first thing you're going to want to do is remove the battery. You don't ever want to begin working on a computer that still has its battery in. Okay, so for the CF31 Mark I, the steps are similar. You just remove this plate. This plate, underneath this plate, there's six screws holding the plate on. Underneath this plate is the wireless WAN card and the RAM. You can access the top stick of RAM on the CF31 Mark I's by removing this plate. If you need to access the bottom slot for the RAM, you have to remove the entire bottom plate for the CF31 Mark I's. The CF31 Mark II's and Mark III's, you can access both slots by removing this plate here. You don't have to remove the entire bottom plate. They've repositioned the RAM slot slightly on the Mark II's and newer CF31's. Okay, so your mobile broadband card or your wireless WAN card is located right here. It's pretty much the same process. You remove the two cables if you already have one in place. In this case, the gray goes to the main and there's a green cable that goes to the auxiliary connector. Just go ahead and remove the two connectors. Undo the screws if you already have a card in place and remove the card. If you don't have a card, you'll simply just, the cable should already be in position. They'll be gray and green. You'll just take your card and slide it into the slot. Or if you're replacing it, you'll take your old card out and replace it with the replacement card. I don't need to do that. I've already, this card, there's nothing wrong with this card. This is just for a demonstration. So go ahead and slide your card back into position and put the screws back in place to hold it in place. And then put the cables back into position in the correct spots. After you put the cables back on, go ahead and put your memory cover back on and put the screws back into position. Be careful not to lose your screws along the way whenever you open up a computer. For us, it's not that much of a big deal because we have plenty of extra screws. But unless you have extra computers laying around for parts, you'll end up having to order some screws or go without. If you do lose your screws and you need some more screws, we do offer screws for the Panasonic Toughbooks on our website at bobjohnson.com. And then go ahead and put your battery back in place once you have the screws back into position. After which you can go ahead and turn your computer on and boot into the BIOS. As I said before, all you do is turn the computer on, and as it's booting, hit the F2 button on your keyboard to boot into the BIOS. You'll want to go to, let me reposition this a little bit. You'll want to go to the third tab that says Advanced. It's the same as the CF19. And you'll want to go down to the wireless configuration, hit enter, and go down and make sure that the wireless WAN is enabled. Once that's done, you can go ahead and boot back into your main operating system. And install the drivers. And I'll show you where to go to get the drivers. I'm not going to show you exactly how to install the drivers because there's many different cards. There's multiple different cards, mobile broadband cards. So it would take too long to show you the install for each and individual one. But I will show you where you can go to get the drivers. Okay, the first thing you're going to want to do is make sure you're connected to a network. And if you're not connected to a network, you go ahead and connect to your network. You'll need an internet connection to be able to download the drivers. Okay, and then just go ahead and open any web browser and go ahead and open up Google. And from Google, just search Panasonic drivers. The first link there, it'll say downloads, computers and tablets, support at Panasonic. That's the link you'll want to click. And from this page here, you can click drivers, BIOS, EC, more to get normal drivers for like your touchscreen, your mouse pad, sound, video, stuff like that. For the Gobi cards, for the Verizon cards, for all the mobile broadband cards, you'll want to go to the wireless carrier software, which is the third one down. You'll just click on that. It'll take you to another page. And you'll want to choose which carrier you're using. If it's an AT&T card, you'll choose AT&T. If it's Sprint, you'll choose Sprint. If it's Verizon, you'll choose Verizon. And if it's a Gobi 1000, 2000, or 3000, or some other multi-carrier software card, you'll choose the multi-carrier software tab. Once you choose the correct carrier, you can scroll down and choose the correct driver for your card. For example, if you have the Gobi 1000 or 2000, it's under the multi-carrier software tab, and it's the first one there. And you'll click on the download and Panasonic just asks for a little bit of information before they'll let you download it. You typically just put in your email address and your name and information, and they'll send you an email with a download link for the driver. That's for the carrier selection application for the Gobi 1000 and 2000. For example, for the Verizon card, you'll go to the Verizon 4G card, the MC7750. You'll just go to the Verizon tab, and you'll download the software for it, which is the VZ Access Manager, the drivers, which is the driver package, and the firmware. And each and every single one of those you can just download. If you have difficulties figuring out which software is correct for you, you can always send us an email to tech_support@bobjohnson.com, and we can try to assist you further. If you have any questions or comments about this video, just let us know. Any questions you have can be directed to the tech support email, which is, yet again, tech_support@bobjohnson.com. Or you can give us a call at our toll-free number of 877-202-7788. Thank you. That'll be all for today for our video.